We're going to start with a little warm-up problem here. Solve the equation x minus 12 equals 7. What we mean by solve the equation is find every value of the variable, that's x here, that makes this equation true. Now, of course, you're just sitting there saying, hey, it's 19. 19 is the number that you subtract 12 from in order to get 7. And that's right. X equals 19. We've found the only value of the variable here that works in this equation, because 19 is the only number we can subtract 12 from in order to get 7. Now that we're all warmed up, let's look at a slightly more challenging problem here. It looks exactly like the previous problem, except we've made the numbers a little bit larger, so you can't just think about the number line or just know the answer immediately. We have to think a little bit here. X is the number that we subtract 287 from in order to get 125. So X must have started 125 larger than 287. So X must have just started off as 125 plus 287, so that when we subtract this 287 off, we're left with 125. Now, another way I like to think about this is, well, I think about it from X's point of view. You know, when you got a bunch of people around you that are driving you nuts, you just want to be alone, right? Your classmates or your teachers, your parents are driving you crazy. You want to get alone and find yourself. And I'm like that too sometimes. Here in the office, people driving me nuts, I come up here in the studio and I talk to you, because you can't talk back. That way I can find myself here in the studio. So we're going to help X do the same thing. X is being driven nuts by this 287. X wants to be alone. We're going to help X. And we're going to get X alone by adding 287, because that'll cancel out the minus 287 there. Now, we can't play favorites with an equation. If we add 287 to one side, we have to add 287 to the other side. If you add the same thing to both sides of the equation, then you're okay. The two sums will still be equal. You start off with two things that are equal, you add the same thing to both, you get two sums that are equal. And that's all we're doing here. But we're strategically choosing what to add. We're adding the 287 so that it cancels with the minus 287 here, and it makes X be all alone, which is what X wants to do. X wants to find itself. It's got to be all alone on one side of the equation. On the other side of the equation, we have 125 plus 287. So we can add that up, 120 plus 280, that's 400. 5 plus 7 is 12, so we get 412. And sure enough, we've solved the equation by doing the same thing to both sides of the equation to get X all alone. Let's try one more. Ooh, fractions. And here, we don't just kind of want to imagine our way to the solution like we did with the x minus 12 equals 7, because, just trying to do that with fractions is hard, and it's easy to make mistakes with fractions, so we have to stay organized. We're going to do the same thing here we did on that last problem. We're going to do the same thing to both sides to get x all alone. Now, here we want to get rid of this 5 and a third that's annoying x, and it's annoying me too. We can get rid of it from this side of the equation by subtracting it. Now, of course, can't play favorites, have to do that on the other side too. So we're going to subtract 5 and a third over there as well. And we subtract 5 and a third from 5 and a third, well, those just cancel out, and we're left with X all alone. And then over here, we have the 2 and a half minus the 5 and a third. And now we have something we know how to handle. We can do the subtraction here. We turn the mixed numbers into fractions. 2 and a half is 5 halves. And the 5 and a third, 5 times 3 is 15, plus the 1, that gives us 16 thirds there. And now we're going to need a common denominator. Let's see, 5, 2 and 3, common denominator is 6, so we'll multiply the top and the bottom here by 3. This is 15 sixths. Here we multiply the top and the bottom by 2. We get 32 over 6. And then we subtract. 15 minus 32 is negative 17. Over 6. Now, of course, the problem is in terms of mixed numbers. We want to write our final answer as a mixed number. So let's see, 17 sixths, well, 12 sixths is 2, so this is negative 2 and 5 sixths. Now, one thing you can do that's really cool with equations is you can check your answer. You can see if you have the right answer here at the end by taking this and sticking it back in here for X and seeing if the equation works. Particularly good idea to do when dealing with fractions, because it's so easy to make mistakes with fractions. So we're going to take that minus 2 and 5 sixths, put it in here, and see if we get the right answer. So we're going to put the minus 2 and 5 sixths in for x. Stick that right in here. We're going to go ahead and add these two numbers and see if we get 2 and a half. We better get 2 and a half. If we didn't get 2 and a half, then we have to go back and start over again because we made a mistake. Let's go ahead and work this out. And again, we're going to turn these mixed numbers into fractions. 5 and a third is 16 thirds. And here we're adding a negative number. That's just the same thing as subtraction. The 2 and 5 sixths, well, we know what that is. That, from before, we know is just 17 sixths. Now we need to find the common denominator, and it's pretty easy. It's just 6, so we double the top and bottom here, and we get 32 over 6 minus 17 over 6. We subtract. 32 minus 17 is 15 over 6. These are both multiples of 3. We can pull out a common factor of 3. That's 3 times 5. That's 3 times 2. We cancel the 3s. And we get 5 halves. And 5 halves as a mixed number is 2 and a half. So sure enough, when we put in x equals negative 2 and 5 sixths into the equation, it works. And we're done.